Good evening. We gather tonight to keep vigil. On this most holy of nights, our new members, River Kimmis and Christian Phelps, will be born into our faith community. As we begin in darkness, there are a few practical things before we start. You will need a printed worship aid, and be sure you have a congregational candle. Please hold your lighted candles upright at all times to prevent dripping wax on the upholstery or pews or floor. When we are ready to extinguish all of our candles, be sure to let the wax harden before you set it down. You'll find baskets at the ends of the pews. Please pass them to your neighbors to collect all the candles. And please supervise all children who are holding candles. The celebration tonight is quite lengthy, but full of all the stories, symbols, and rituals of our faith tradition. If you are visiting our parish tonight, we extend a word of welcome and invite you to participate in whatever way you are comfortable. As we now move outdoors around the new Easter fire, please allow Father Phil, River, and Christian, and their families to leave first. Then we can all follow. Please pick up a candle on your way out the door. If you need an elevator to get downstairs, please look for one of the ushers in the family room and they will help you. We will all walk around to the fire pit downstairs, located around the corner by the pond.
Thank you. Dear friends in Christ, we have begun our solemn vigil. Let us now listen attentively to the Word of God, recalling how God's people were saved throughout history and how we are saved in Christ Jesus our Lord. Please be seated for scripture readings.
A reading from the book of Genesis. In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. Now, the earth was a formless void. There was darkness over the deep, and God's Spirit hovered over the water. God said, "Let there be light." And there was light. God saw the light was good, and God divided light from darkness. God called the light day, and the darkness God called night. The first day. God said, "Let there be a vault in the waters to divide the waters in two." And so it was. God made the vault, and it divided the waters above the vault from the waters under the vault. God called the vault heaven. The second day. Said, "Let the waters under heaven come together into a single mass, and let dry land appear." And so it was. God made the vault, and it divided the waters above the vault from the waters under the vault. God called the vault heaven. Oh my goodness. The second day. God said, "Let the waters under heaven come together into a single mass, and let dry land appear." And so it was. God called the dry land earth, and the mass of waters God called the seas, and God saw that it was good. God said, "Let the earth produce vegetation, seed-bearing plants, and fruit trees bearing fruit with its seed inside." And so it was. The earth produced vegetation, plants bearing seed in their several kinds, and trees bearing fruit with their seed inside in their several kinds. God saw that it was good. The third day.
Morning came,
God said, "Let there be lights in the vault of heaven to divide day from night, and let them indicate festivals, days and years. Let there be lights in the vault of heaven to shine on the earth." And so it was. God made the two great lights, the sun to govern the day, and the stars and the moon to govern the night. God set them in the vault of heaven to shine on the earth, to govern the day and the night, and to divide light from darkness. God saw that it was good. The fourth day. God said, "Let the waters teem with living creatures, and let birds fly above the earth within the vault of heaven." And so it was. God created great sea serpents and every kind of living creature with which the waters teem, and every kind of winged creature. God saw that it was good. God blessed them, saying, "Be fruitful, multiply, fill the waters of the seas, and let the birds multiply upon the earth." The fifth day. God said, "Let the earth produce every kind of living creature, cattle, reptiles, and every kind of wild beast." And so it was. God made every kind of wild beast, every kind of cattle, and every kind of land reptile. God saw that it was good. Then God said, "Let us make people in our own image, after our likeness. Let them have stewardship over the fish of the sea, and over the birds of the air, and over the cattle, and over all the wild beasts, and over every creeping thing that crawls upon the earth." God created people in God's own image. In the image of God, they were created, male and female. They were created. God blessed them, saying, "Be fruitful, multiply, fill the earth and conquer it. Have stewardship over the fish of the sea, the birds of the air, and all living animals on the earth." God said, "See, I give you all the fruit, all the seed-bearing plants that grow upon the earth, and all the trees with seed-bearing fruit. This shall be your food. To all wild beasts, all birds of heaven, and all things that crawl upon the earth, I give all the foliage of plants for food." And so it was. God saw all that had been created, and indeed it was very good. The sixth day. Thus the heavens and the earth were completed with all their array. On the seventh day, God completed the work that had been undertaken, and God rested after all the work which had been done. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. At this time, I invite you to blow out your candles and hold them up until the wax hardens. And you'll find baskets at the end of your pews. Pass them down as the wax hardens.
Send forth your Spirit, O God. Send forth your Spirit, O God, and renew the earth, renew the earth. Send forth your Spirit, O give plans for the life of your creatures. Food for strength, wine for joy, oil for gladness. Mighty trees, the cedars of Lebanon, where the birds and storks shall make their home. You have made the moon to mark the seasons, told the sun when to rise and when to set. You make night for the creatures of the forest. They seek food from the hand of their God.
A reading from the book of Genesis. God put Abraham to the test. He called to him, "Abraham." "Here I am," he replied. Then God said, "Take your son Isaac, your only one, whom you love, and go to the land of Moriah. There you shall offer him up as a holocaust on a height that I will point out to you." Early the next morning, Abraham saddled his donkey, took with him his son Isaac, and two of his servants as well, and with the wood he had cut for the holocaust, set out for the place of which God had told him. On the third day, Abraham got sight of the place from afar. Then he said to his servants, "Both of you stay here with the donkey, while the boy and I go over yonder. We will worship and then come back to you." Thereupon Abraham took the wood for the holocaust and laid it upon Isaac's shoulders, while he himself carried the fire and the knife. As the two walked on together, Isaac spoke to his father Abraham. "Father," Isaac said.
"Yes, son,"
he replied. Isaac continued, "Here are the fire and the wood, but where is the sheep for the holocaust?"
"Son," Abram answered, "God himself will provide the sheep for the holocaust."
Then the two continued going forward. When they came to the place of which God had told him, Abraham built an altar there and arranged the wood on it. Next, he tied up his son Isaac and put him on top of the wood on the altar. Then he reached out and took the knife to slaughter his son. But the Lord's messenger called to him from heaven, "Abraham, Abraham."
"Here I am," he answered. "Do not lay your hand on the boy," said the messenger. "Do not do the least thing to him. I know now how devoted you are to God, since you did not withhold from me your own beloved son."
As Abraham looked about, he spied a ram caught by its horns in the thicket. So he went and took the ram and offered it up as a holocaust in place of his son. Abraham named the place Yahweh Yireh. Hence people now say, "On the mountain the Lord will see." Again, the Lord's messenger called to Abraham from heaven and said,
"I swear by myself, declares the Lord, that because you acted as you did in not withholding from me your beloved son, I will bless you abundantly and make your descendants as countless as the stars of the sky and the sands of the seashore. Your descendants shall take possession of the gates of their enemies, and in your descendants all the nations of the earth shall find blessing, all because you obeyed my command." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Please stand.
Inheritance, O Lord, you are my inheritance.
Please be seated.
A reading from the book of Exodus. The Lord said to Moses, "Why are you crying out to me? Tell the Israelites to go forward, and you lift up your staff, and with hand outstretched over the sea, split the sea in two. The Israelites may pass through it on dry land, but I will make the Egyptians so obstinate that they will go in after them. Then I will receive glory through Pharaoh and all his army, his chariots and charioteers. The Egyptians shall know that I am the Lord, when I receive glory through Pharaoh and his chariots and charioteers."
Sing the
song of freedom.
Sing the song of freedom.
God has won the victory.
God has won the victory.
Horse and chariot are cast into the sea.
Horse and chariot are cast into the sea.
The angel of God, who had been leading Israel's camp, now moved and went around behind them, the column of cloud also, leaving the front, took up its place behind them. It came between the camp of the Egyptians and that of Israel, but the cloud now became dark, and thus the night passed without the rival camps coming any closer together all night long.
Sing the song of freedom.
God has won the victory.
God has won the victory.
Horse and chariot are cast into the sea.
Horse and chariot are cast into the sea.
Then Moses stretched out his hand over the sea, and the Lord swept the sea with a strong east wind throughout the night, and so turned it into dry land. When the water was thus divided, the Israelites marched into the midst of the sea on dry land, with the water like a wall to their right and to their left.
Sing the song of freedom.
Sing the song of freedom.
God has won the victory.
God has won the victory.
Horse and chariot are cast into the sea. The Egyptians followed in pursuit. All Pharaoh's horses and chariots and charioteers went after them, right into the midst of the sea. In the night watch, just before dawn, the Lord cast the column of the fiery cloud upon the Egyptian force, a glance that threw it into a panic. He so clogged the chariot wheels that they could hardly drive. With that, the Egyptians sounded the retreat before Israel, because the Lord was fighting for them against the Egyptians. Sing the song of freedom. God has won the victory. Are cast into the sea. Then the Lord said to Moses, stretch out your hand over the sea, that the water may flow back upon the Egyptians, upon their chariots and charioteers. So Moses stretched out his hand over the sea, and at dawn the sea flowed back to its normal depth. The Egyptians were fleeing head on toward the sea when the Lord hurled them into its midst. Sing the song of freedom. God has won the victory. Horse and chariot are cast into the sea. As the water flowed back, it covered the chariots and charioteers of Pharaoh's whole army, which had followed the Israelites into the sea. Not a single one of them escaped. But the Israelites had marched on dry land through the midst of the sea, with the water like a wall to their right and to their left. Thus the Lord saved Israel on that day from the power of the Egyptians. Sing the song of freedom. God has won the victory. Chariot are cast into the sea. When Israel saw the Egyptians lying dead on the seashore and beheld the great power that the Lord had shown against the Egyptians, they feared the Lord and believed in him and in his servant Moses. Then Moses and the Israelites sang this song to the Lord. Sing the song of freedom. God has won the victory. Horse and chariot are cast into the sea. Sing the song of freedom. God has won the victory. Horse and chariot are cast into the sea. Horse and chariot, fear and loneliness, death and emptiness. chariot are cast into the sea. Horse and chariot, hate and prejudice, chains and slavery, horse and chariot are cast into the sea.
A reading from the prophet Isaiah. Sing, O barren one who did not bear. Burst into song and shout, you who have not been in labor. For the children of the desolate woman will be more than the children of her that is married, says the Lord. Enlarge the site of your tent, and let its walls be stretched out. Do not hold back. Lengthen your cords and strengthen your stakes, for you will spread out to the right and to the left, and your descendants will possess the nations and will settle the desolate towns. Do not fear, for you will not be ashamed and not be discouraged. For you will not suffer disgrace. For the one who has become your husband is your maker. His name is the Lord of hosts. The Lord calls you back, like a wife forsaken and grieved in spirit, like a wife married in youth and then cast off. For a brief moment, I abandoned you. But with great tenderness, I will take you back. In an outburst of wrath, I hid my face from you for a moment. But with enduring love, I take pity on you. This is for me, like the days of Noah, when I swore that the waters should never again flood the earth. So I have sworn not to be angry with you. Though the mountains fall and the hills be shaken, my love shall never leave you, nor shall my covenant of peace be shaken, says the Lord. O afflicted one, storm, battered and unconsoled, I lay your pavements in carnelians and your foundations in sapphires. I will make your pinnacles of rubies, and your gates of jewels, and all your walls of precious stones. All your children shall be taught by the Lord, and great shall be the peace of your children. In justice shall you be established, far from the fear of oppression, where destruction cannot come near you. The word of the Lord.
Thank you. let my enemies rejoice over me. O Lord, you have lifted up my soul from the grave, restored me to life from those who sink into the pit. I will praise you, Lord, for you have rescued me. I will praise you, Lord, for you have rescued me. Sing psalms to the Lord, you faithful ones. Give thanks to his holy name. His anger lasts a moment, his favor all through life. At night come tears, but dawn brings joy. I will praise you, Lord, for you have rescued me. I will praise you, Lord, for you have rescued me. Hear, O Lord, and have mercy on me. Be my helper, O Lord. You have changed my mourning into dancing. O Lord, my God, I will thank you forever. I will praise you, Lord, for you have rescued me. I will praise you, Lord, for you have rescued me. I will praise you, Lord, for you have rescued me. I will praise you, Lord, for you have rescued me.
A reading from the prophet Isaiah. All you who are thirsty, come to the water. You who have no money, come, receive grain and eat. Come without paying and without cost. Drink wine and milk. Why spend your money for what is not bread? Your wages for what fails to satisfy. Heed me, and you shall eat well. You shall delight in rich fare. Come to me heedfully. Listen, that you may have life. I will renew you the everlasting covenant, the benefits assured to David. Seek me, your God, while I may be found. Call upon me while I am still near. Let the scoundrels forsake their ways and the evil their thoughts. Let them turn back to me, that I may take pity on them and bestow on them my abundant pardon. For my thoughts are not your thoughts, nor are your ways my ways. For as the heavens are high above the earth, so are my ways higher than your ways, and my thoughts higher than your thoughts. For just as from the heavens the rain and snow come down and do not return there until they have watered the earth, and making it fertile and fruitful, giving seed to those who sow and bread to those who eat. So shall my word be that goes forth from my mouth. It shall not return empty, it shall not return to me empty, but shall carry out my will, achieving the end for which I sent it. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Please stand.
With joy you shall draw water from the springs of endless life. With joy you shall draw water from the living well of God. With joy you shall draw water from the springs of you shall draw water from the endless well of God. God indeed is my Savior. I will never be afraid. My strength and courage is the Lord, my Savior and my song. You shall draw water from the springs of endless life. With joy you shall draw water from the living well of God. Give thanks and praise the name of God. Sing out to
a reading from the prophet Baruch. Hear, O Israel, the commandments of life. Listen and know prudence. How is it, Israel, that you are in the land of your foes, grown old in a foreign land, defiled with the dead, accounted with those destined for the netherworld? You have forsaken the fountain of wisdom. Had you walked in the way of God, you would have dwelt in enduring peace. Learn where prudence is, where strength, where understanding, that you may know also where are length of days and life, where light of the eyes and peace. Who has found the place of wisdom? Who has entered into her treasuries? The one who knows all things knows her. He has probed her by his knowledge. The one who established the earth for all time and filled it with four-footed beasts. He who dismisses the light and it departs, calls it and it obeys him, trembling. Before whom the stars at their posts shine and rejoice. When he calls them, they answer, "Here we are," shining with joy for their maker. Such is our God. No other is to be compared to him. He has traced out the whole way of understanding and has given her to Jacob, his servant, to Israel, his beloved son. Since then, she has appeared on earth and moved among people. She is the book of the precepts of God, the law that endures forever. All who cling to her will live, but those will die who forsake her. Turn, O Jacob, and receive her. Walk by her light toward splendor. Give not your glory to another, your privileges to an alien race. Blessed are we, O Israel, for what pleases God is known to us. The word of the Lord.
A reading from the book of the prophet Ezekiel. I will take you from the nations and gather you from all the countries and bring you back into your own land. I will sprinkle clean water upon you, and you shall be clean from all your impurities and from all your idols. I will cleanse you. A new heart I will give you, and a new spirit I will put within you. And I will remove from your body the heart of stone and give you a heart of flesh. I will put my spirit within you and make you follow my statutes and be careful to observe my ordinances. Then you shall live in the land that I gave your ancestors, and you shall be my people, and I will be your God. I will save you from your sins, and I will summon the grain and make it abundant and lay no more famine on you. I will make the fruit of the trees and the produce of the fields abundant, so that you may never again suffer the disgrace of famine among the nations. The word of the Lord.
As the days for running streams,
Please stand. Let us pray. God, you have brightened this night with the radiance of the risen Christ. Quicken the spirit of Christ within your church. Renew us in mind and body so that we may serve you wholeheartedly. Grant this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from St. Paul's letter to the Romans. You have been taught that when we were baptized into Christ Jesus, we were baptized into his death. In other words, as we were baptized, we were buried with him in the tomb and joined him in death, so that just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might live a new life. If in union with Christ we have imitated his death, we shall also imitate him in his resurrection. We must realize that our former selves have been crucified with him to destroy these sinful bodies of ours and to free us from the slavery of sin. When a person dies, they are finished with sin, but we believe that having died with Christ, we shall return to life in him. We know that Christ, once raised from the dead, will never die again. Death has no more power over him. When he died to sin once for all. So his life now is life with God. And in that way, you too must consider yourselves to be dead to sin, but alive, for God is in Christ Jesus. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Glory to you, O Lord. Lord, be on my thoughts. Lord, be on my lips. Lord, live in my heart. After the Sabbath, as the first day of the week was dawning, Mary Magdalene and the other Mary came to see the tomb. And behold, there was a great earthquake, and an angel of the Lord descended from heaven, approached, rolled back the stone, and sat on it. His appearance was like lightning, and his clothing was white as snow. The guards were shaken with fear of him and became like dead men. Then the angel said to the women in reply, "Do not be afraid." Say it with me. Do not be afraid. I know that you are seeking Jesus, the crucified. He is not here, for he has been raised just as he said. Come and see the place where he lay. Then go quickly and tell his disciples he has been raised from the dead. Say it with me. He has been raised from the dead. And he is going before you to Galilee. There you will see him. Behold, I have told you. Then the women went away quickly from the tomb, fearful yet overjoyed, and ran to announce this to his disciples. And behold, Jesus met them on their way and greeted them. They approached, embraced his feet, and did him homage. Then Jesus said to them, "Do not be afraid." Say it with me. Do not be afraid. Go tell my other disciples to go to Galilee, and there you will see me. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated. Thank you all for coming out this evening, for all that this evening has to hold for us. Who are those disciples? It's each and every one of us who have been baptized. Each and every one of us are called, do not be afraid, but tell the world the good news that he is risen. Tonight, as we continue with our celebration, with the ceremonies and the actions, let the Holy Spirit come on in. Relax. Be at comfort. And when you and I begin to drift off, come on, Holy Spirit, say it with me. Come on, Holy Spirit. You and I will be amazed. You and I will be amazed. So without further ado, we continue with our ceremony. We have our liturgy of initiation calling forth to be baptized. Let the one who wishes to die and rise with Christ through the waters of baptism stand now as I call your name, River Thomas Moore Kimmis. Dear friends, let us pray to Almighty God for River, who is asking for baptism. God has called him and led him here tonight. May God grant River light and strength to follow Christ with a determined heart and to profess the faith of the church. We have the Litany of the Saints.
Mary, Mother of God, Saint Joseph,
Abraham and Sarah,
pray for us.
Isaac and Moses, Joshua and David,
pray for us.
Isaiah, Jeremiah,
pray for us.
Saints Joachim and Anne,
pray
for us.
We have the blessing of the water. Almighty and eternal God, you give us grace through sacramental signs. which tell us of the wonders of your unseen power. Throughout all of history, you have blessed your people with the gift of water. In baptism, we use your gift of water, which you have made a rich symbol of the grace. At the very dawn of creation, your Spirit breathed on the waters, making them a wellspring of all holiness. Through the waters of the great flood and Noah's time, you put an end to sin and ushered in a new beginning of goodness. Through the waters of the Red Sea, you led Israel out of slavery to be an image of God's holy people, set free. In the waters of the Jordan, your son was baptized by John and was anointed with the Spirit. Again and again, you showed us your power through the image of water. When your son willed that water and blood should flow from his side as he hung upon the cross. And after his resurrection, Jesus told us, "Go out to all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit." I invite all of us to extend a hand of blessing over the water in this font. Father, look now with love upon your church and unseal for us this font of baptism. By the power of the Holy Spirit, give to this water the grace of your Son, so that all those whom you have created in your likeness may be cleansed from sin and rise to new birth of innocence by water and the Holy Spirit. We ask this through Christ our Lord, and the church said,
Amen.
May the power of the Holy Spirit, O God, we pray, come down through your Son in the fullness of this font, so that all who have been buried with Christ by baptism into death, by rising again with him who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. Father, Son, Holy Spirit, three in one. We have the renewal of baptismal promises. Please stand. Through the Paschal mystery, we have been buried with Christ so that we may rise with him to new life. Now that we have completed our Lenten observance and are preparing to share in the Easter sacraments, let us renew the promise we made at our baptism. As we renew our promises, we invite River Chemist and Christian Phelps, who have been preparing to join the church, to profess their faith for the first time with us. Please respond, "I do," to the following question. Do you reject sin so as to live in the freedom of God's children?
I do.
Do you reject the glamour of evil and refuse to be mastered by sin?
I do.
Do you reject Satan, father of sin and prince of darkness?
I do.
And now for our profession of faith. Do you believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth? Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, was crucified, died, and was buried, and rose from the dead, and is now seated at God's right hand?
Amen.
Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sin, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting?
Amen.
This is our faith. This is the faith of the church. If you are proud to profess it, then say amen.
Amen.
All right, sit down. At this time, we have our baptism. Okay, who's going to hold the book for me? I go down first. I go down first. Yeah, leave it on. Oh, good. I go down first. Okay. Somebody hold my hand. You get to an age. It is toasty. River, come on in. It's fine. Kneel down and face that way. River, I baptize you in the name of the Father.
Alleluia.
And in the name of the Son.
Alleluia.
And of the Holy Spirit. River comes up out of the font. Rob. Okay. Before I get out, once I get out, I invite everyone assembled to come forward at this time and sign yourself, sign of the cross in the waters of baptism. When you reach the baptismal font, several can congregate around it at the same time. Bless yourselves in the water.
Waiting in
Moving forward with our ceremony. I now ask Rob to light River's baptismal candle from the Easter candle and present it to River. I'll stand next to you. There. Till he gets back. Rob, please give the East baptismal candle to River. River, you have been enlightened by Christ. Walk always as a child of the light and keep the flame of faith alive in your heart. And when the Lord comes, may you go out to meet him with all the saints in the heavenly kingdom. We ask this through Christ our Lord, and the church said, we have reception into full communion. At this time, I call Christian Phelps to be received into full communion in the Catholic Church. Christian, you have already experienced the cleansing waters of baptism in another Christian denomination. Christian, we know that you have been walking the journey toward becoming Catholic for the last several months, and so we ask you, do you believe and profess what the Holy Catholic Church believes, teaches, and proclaims to be revealed by God?
I do believe.
The Lord receives you into the Church. God's love has led you here so that in the unity of the Holy Spirit, you may have full communion with us through the faith you have professed in the presence of this community. Applause. The sacrament of confirmation. Born again in Christ by baptism, you have become a member of Christ and of his priestly people. Now you are to share in the outpouring of the Holy Spirit among us, the Spirit sent by the Lord upon the apostles at Pentecost. This Spirit will enlighten you to be an active member of the church. Laying on of hands. My dear friends in Christ, let us pray to God our Father that he will pour out the Holy Spirit on these candidates for confirmation to strengthen them with his gifts and anoint them to be like Christ. All-powerful God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, by water and the Holy Spirit, you freed your sons and daughters from sin and gave them new birth. Send your Holy Spirit upon River and Christian to be their helper and guide. Give them the spirit of wisdom and understanding, the spirit of right judgment and courage, the spirit of knowledge and reverence, the spirit of wonder and awe in your presence. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord, and the church said,
amen.
We have the imposition of hands at this time, where I'll have my hands over their head and we all pray for the Holy Spirit. the anointing with chrism. At this time, I ask Rob and Matt to place a hand on River and Christian's shoulder as I anoint them with the oil of chrism. Thomas Moore, I anoint you with the oil of chrism. Peace be with you.
And also with you.
And also with you.
Amen. Pius, I anoint you the seal, holy oil, Father, Son, Holy Spirit. Amen. Peace be with you. We welcome River and Christian and invite them to share at the Eucharistic table. Have a seat. Have a seat. Blessed are you Lord God of all creation, through your goodness we have this bread to offer, which earth has given and human hands hath made. It will become for us our spiritual food. By the mingling of this water and wine, may we come to share in the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself to share in our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this wine to offer. Fruit of the vine, a work of human hands, it will become for us our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Lord God, wash away our iniquities, cleanse us from our sin. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that our sacrifice be acceptable to God, our Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the whole church.
Grant to us, O God, a heart renewed. Recreate in us your own spirit, Lord. Accept the prayers of your people this night with the sacrificial offerings, that what has begun in the Paschal mysteries may, by working of your power, bring us to the healing of eternity. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Father, but especially on this night, above all, to praise you more generously and gloriously, when Christ, our Passover, has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying, Jesus has destroyed our death. By rising, Jesus restored our life. And so we join the angels and saints in song. God, you are holy. Let your spirit come upon these gifts to make them holy, that they may become for us the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed, Jesus took bread and gave you thanks, Father, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." When supper was ended, Jesus took the chalice. Again he gave you praise and thanks, Father. Gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sin. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection
until you come again.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
We celebrate the memorial of his passion, death, and resurrection. And we offer you, God, our Father, the bread of life, the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and serve you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by your Holy Spirit. Lord, remember your church gathered here at Holy Family tonight and all over your world. Help us to grow in charity together with Francis, our Pope, James, our Bishop, all the clergy and all your people. God, our Father, remember our brothers and sisters who have died. All who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, welcome them home into the light of your presence. And thank you, God, for having mercy on us. And we pray that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Joseph, her spouse, the apostles and saints, we too may merit eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Together we stand, and we pray that prayer that Jesus taught us, whose Father?
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us, Lord, from every evil. Grant us peace in our day. Keep us free from sin. Protect us from daily anxiety as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Look not on our sin, but on the faith of your church. Grant us peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
We don't know the day. We don't know the hour. Tomorrow is not promised, but we're here today. So thank God for that saint on your left. Thank God for that saint on your right. Let us offer each other some sign of Christ's peace. Please kneel or be seated. I would ask that the congregation allow the two new Catholics to receive first. In just a moment, I will lift high the body and blood of Jesus Christ. I invite all of us to look upon Jesus, believe in his real presence, invite him into our hearts, pray this prayer as if it were the last prayer of our lives. Behold the Lamb of God, behold Jesus, who takes away the sin of the world and heals us. Blessed are we who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord.
Hallelujah.
What are you thankful for? How is God blessing you? Close your eyes for a quick second. See yourself walking with God. Turn to God and simply say, God, I want to thank you for. Take a quiet moment. Amen?
Amen.
Please stand and let us pray. God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit, three in one, watch over your church and bring us to the glory of the resurrection promised by this Easter sacrament. We ask this through Christ, our Passover and our peace, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Just one announcement. Everyone is invited downstairs to the parish hall for a phenomenal reception. I've tasted most of the desserts. We have a final solemn blessing. Please, a hearty amen at the end of each prayer. May Almighty God bless you on this solemn feast, and may the Holy One protect you against all sin. Through the resurrection of his Son, the Father has granted healing to all people. May the promise of God be fulfilled by blessing you with eternal life.
Amen.
You have mourned the Christ's suffering. Now you celebrate the joy of his resurrection. May you come with joy to the feast which lasts forever.
Amen.
And may Almighty God bless us all, Father, Son, Holy Spirit.
Amen.